the time for the delicious portion of our program this morning. As we head over to the Wood Harbor Kitchen, we always say it's a great day to grill, and we're going to prove that to you today as we get some great ideas with Galen from Decked Out Size. And, of course, Lou, what you guys got going on?
Oh, we love it when Galen comes over because you know it's going to be a tasty portion of the program. And it almost looks healthy, Galen. What's going on here?
Well, we try to be healthy. Than maybe we were at one time, but we're doing something a little bit different. The old basic burger on the grill. It's mm-hmm. grilling with Galen. That's a great thing to do. We encourage that. But we took it up a notch this morning.
All right. What did you do?
I got up early and I spent a couple hours cooking a burger for you.
Okay, a couple of hours cooking a burger.
Couple of hours.
All right. Why did it take a couple of hours?
Well, because these aren't grilled burgers.
What are they?
They're smoked. Burgers.
Smoked. So these are cooked slowly. Then.
Very, 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 very slowly. And we went outside and went to a whole lot of effort this morning. About 4:30 this morning I got up and I went outside of my deck and I have this beautiful new Smokin' Brothers pellet grill mm-hmm. and I turned the knob.
You put that much effort into getting it.
I know. It's just for you, buddy, because I care.
He gives, and then he gives some more.
Yeah.
All right, so you got it up to temperature. Now, did you cook it up? Did you click it over to smoke? Did you cook it over to 200?
What 225.
Temperature? 225.
Yep. On a Smokin' Brothers pellet grill, you start it out 180 degrees, and within 4 minutes, you've got the fire and the fire pot ignited. We've showed the pellets before. And then you turn it to whatever temperature you want to cook at. In this case, I put it at 225. Put the burgers on. Went down to Norwalk and saw my favorite butcher, and got some burger patties. And that's all really there was to it.
Now you smoke these at a low temperature, so you seriously they took a long time to cook.
Yeah, you want to you know what we're trying to do. Obviously, is we're trying to put a lot of smoky flavor into the meat I hope we accomplish that.
Now, is that when it gets the most flavor is when it's at lower temperatures?
Well, absolutely, because it's a combination of what you're doing is you're taking a lot of duration, a lot of time, and of course, all of that smoke. Pellets in the Smokin' Brothers pellet grill this morning were hickory, so we've got hopefully a lot of hickory flavor coming through.
Permeates
through the meat, and you do want to be a little bit careful when you're smoking. You want to take it up to temperature. 160 degrees is what we wanted to take these to. You don't want to turn them into shoe leather, mm-hmm. But you want to make sure that they're done at the same time because bacteria can form over that long a period of time,
okay.
And you're not cooking with a very, very high temperature. So,
got it.
So you want to use exercise some caution. So we did a couple of patties plain, used a little bit of Worcestershire.
If you haven't used Worcestershire sauce for a while, like Lee and Perrins, kick it up a notch.
Lee and Perrins is definitely the way to go.
And it's gluten-free, too, in case you didn't know, contrary to popular belief.
Absolutely. So we put a little bit of Dizzy Pig rub.
Of course.
Used the cowlick steak rub this morning. Put a little bit of that on put it on the grill. And then for the last 15 minutes, I took a couple of the patties and I put a little Havarti cheese on there. Just to provide a little bit of additional flavor, and we fixed up some fixins, some basic sweet pickles and some prosciutto this mm-hmm. morning, fresh sliced prosciutto. Last night when we were doing our family meal, I was also grilling at a little bit higher temperature. I walked into the store earlier this week, and I've told you about this before. There's about four times a year where you can find red jalapeno peppers. Okay, not the green ones, but these are fully ripened jalapenos. Buy them. Buy all that they have and take them home. A couple of different things that I love to do with them. These are just roasted. And just like you would a bell pepper, I just roasted them so you get that tough
skin
off of there. If you like a little bit of heat, you can throw one of those on your burger. But they keep in the refrigerator for a long time, and just great to add any kind of flavor to anything that you're doing. The other thing that I love to do, and I haven't done that, but I just went back last night and I bought like 3 pounds of them. I'll throw those on and I'll smoke them. Smoke them at a very, very low temperature, probably 140, 150 degrees for maybe 18, 20 hours. Completely dry them out, and then they become chipotle.
There you go.
Okay, you get that real smoky flavor.
All right, so you have it all done. You also did some, remember, today's veggie day.
It's veggie day.
So you need to get vegetables into your diet today. You look like you smoked up some veggies.
Just threw a little balsamic in there with some sweet Vidalia onions. They're also in right now. Some tomatoes and some bell peppers. And
how long did you cook these?
Those were on a little bit longer than the burgers. I put those on right away when I got up this morning, so they were on close to 3 hours.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Mr. Parker, are you going to join us?
Oh, I guess so.
Okay, you created your...
I don't know if you like this. It's just a little garlic aioli, but I started a burger
Slather
for you.
Slather some of that on?
Well, actually, it's on the bottom
on the bottom
so
here?
I think if you want to tip that over, put whatever else on it that you might want, Jason.
I
got one for you there.
Oh, thank you.
You know what? I forgot to bring a sharp knife.
Just see if there's a knife in the drawers here.
Just jump in.
We'll just dive into it.
Forget it. Okay. We're all family.
I'm not making this up because you're here. I walked into Decked Outside last month.
Oh, my God.
And I haven't been there. I don't get out much.
Thank you. I wasn't there.
And I literally gasped because the store is such a cool place.
This is unreal.
So many cool things in there.
That's very nice. That's very nice.
Smoke flavor.
You getting that smoke
flavor
in there?
As soon as you put your mouth around it, jumps out at you.
I think you said something that that Jackie was interested
here,
in.
Here, take a bite.
About unreal.
No, that's mine. Jeez. You got to bolt everything down.
Is that
exactly.
Awesome?
Exactly.
Now, we're talking about Galen knowing how to smoke and how to do all this. And, Jason, if you go in the refrigerator on the top shelf, there's a baggie in there, Ziploc for Galen. But if we go to the surface, I'm going to show you what Galen did via proxy yesterday. This is a hunk of salmon that I put on our smoker yesterday, the pellet grill smoker. And, Galen, check this out. There it is in the smoking process yesterday. And when it was done, per Galen's instructions via phone, we came up, and I've never tried this on the pellet grill before, the smoking grill. We've got to check it out. This is all you're doing.
Looks good.
You talk about role reversal. I love this. Lou's making food for me and bringing it in. I love this.
This is how he could teach even a novice like yours truly
delicious.
How to make.
That is
good?
Outstanding.
Sam's Club is where we got the meat from. Ding, ding, ding.
You know, all this stuff. If you have the right equipment, Lou, it's just so easy to do. It doesn't take a lot of effort and a lot of time.
It
takes a little bit of planning, but, you know, just get out there.
No question about it.
Yeah.
So, folks, if you need any of the supplies for this, any of the knowledge from this man here, Decked Outside is where you need to go over on Urbandale Drive. Stop in, see Galen. He'll walk you through it. Anybody can do this and have perfection when you're done cooking.
So good.
Isn't that great?
Thank you.
Isn't that a great burger?
Thank you.
All right, Galen. Great job as always, man. High five. Good job.
All right.
We'll be
High
right
five.
Back. This is Great Day Live on KCWI.